I'll let y'all decide how y'all want to handle these, or who wants to answer. Bruce alluded to Invest Georgia. The chamber is advocating for the funding of Invest Georgia. Just don't know how that's going to happen. We know that tax credits have been talked about being sold to fund that, but what do you see as possible funding sources, and will that be something that's taken up during this session?
It doesn't matter where the source comes from, folks, you're talking about money. And if you make a tax credit, that's a tax expenditure, really. I mean, so, yeah, it's 6 1/2 dozen the other. The main thing that to make this happen is you've got to have a commitment to it, and we've got to be able to get commitment out of our leadership, out of the governor's office, it's just like funding for transportation. It takes leadership to make these things happen, and you get the leadership committed to it, it'll happen.
We have recently heard about the possibility of designating Lowndes County as an inland port. Just would like your general thoughts on that, what the feasibility of that is, and what kind of opportunities that would open up for our county, our region.
Okay, in that, a lot of times we have either an inactive, proactive, or reactive community. Okay, we know that Cordell, places like that, have been looked at and said, you know, this may be the end of the port operation here, you know, one of them anyway. But what we have to do, even though we want to be designated, but if we're not designated, we still have the opportunity to prepare ourselves, because you're going to have a lot of more traffic coming in, you're going to have a lot of opportunity in this area. So what we need to do, position ourselves and say, look, let's get ourselves in a position as though we are not designated, but do everything we need to do to let them know that Valdosta is ready to be a regional designee, or if we're not, we can still make money off this whole project. And through the mayor and the county commissioner chair, Slaughter, them works together already, this will make this project better. You've got the state, we got our local people here. We can work this thing, and even if we've already shown them that we're trying to work together and make something happen, that will make us look at better to be designated. And we also see that there's going to be a lot of traffic coming through with 18-wheelers and truckers. Once that port gets open, everything's moving, people are going to come through Valdosta. So we need to make sure, get with DOT, make sure all those things are good as far as our roads. But in the private sector of this thing, when you got a lot of truckers coming through an area, sometimes they're going to break down, right? So I would like to see us go ahead, be proactive, get on Industrial Authority and several others and say, you know what? Let's position ourselves in the Valdosta area for some type of manufacturing and diesel, okay? Mechanic shops here. We already have, through the governor, giving extra funding at Wiregrass and places for diesel mechanics. That's what we call putting the pieces together to know that, hey, we have the education, we have jobs here. So what we need to do is get ahead of the game, go ahead and start working together, let the government and everybody else know that Valdosta is already prepared. Even though we may not be designated, we're going to act like we're designated and prepare ourselves. So I think that's what we need to do, is to work together and go ahead and prepare ourselves so that we can be in a great position to be designated. But if not, we can still, you know, make profits and create jobs in this community.
Anything to add?
Yeah, let me add this. We're in a unique situation in that we can move forward with this because this concept is based on loading some of these container units on rail and shipping them out to port into an area and then branching out for delivery from there. And so it's not a matter of the truck hauling the stuff into Valdosta. It's going to come, that would be coming into a inland port, which is Valdosta or Cordell. We are in one big advantage over Cordell moving forward in this, and we've got good rail connection between Valdosta and the port. And the big obstacle that Cordell is faced with is the tracks between Cordell and the ports. are in bad need of some mega bucks to get them up to snuff, to be able to handle the traffic with this, to be involved with the planned increase in volume of containers coming into that port.
Help me thank these members of our local delegation.